Good day, viewers. My name is Etolo Anslem-Tayedobra. My topic this morning is exploiting innovations for sustainable development in the era of COVID-19. As we are aware, we are in challenging times as a result of the global pandemic caused by the coronavirus, which has ravaged all economies of the world. Governments all over the world are looking for new ways of doing business, as well as citizens and corporate organizations who offer one kind of service or the other. A lot of these organizations are faced with the challenge of how do we attend to their clients, especially in the old order where we do business by meeting physically. But today, with the help of technology, we have found ourselves in a global community where we have innovations in the internet, on social media, on different platforms where you are able to meet and interact with your clients. For instance, if you are into communications, that's the ICT services, the period of COVID-19 has thrown up opportunities for those in that sector, because a lot of activities is being carried out on the social media, on the mass media, and these services are driven by technological experts. Let us go into the real topic for the discussion, which is managing innovations in the era of COVID-19. How do we revive our economy? Because as it is today, there's a decline in economic activities because of certain levels of restrictions placed by governments in order to keep our people safe. But be that as it may, there are new opportunities that has been provided as a result of the global pandemic, such as manufacturing. Much premium is now placed on manufacturing, because for us to have proper economic recovery, there has to be increased production of goods and services that will be able to meet the local consumption and demand. In our country, Nigeria, we are an import-dependent nation. We depend largely on imported goods. But as we are today, getting goods and services into Nigeria is an Herculean task. And the cost of bringing such goods is on a very high side. But some of these goods are goods that we can actually manufacture in Nigeria. If we look deep into our system, we'll be able to go into production of such goods, which will in turn create jobs for our teeming youths and our people. Primarily, before the advent of oil, Nigeria had a thriving agricultural sector. But we now saw that oil money was easy money, and as a result, successive administrations failed to grow the agricultural sector, because at the end of every month, we wait for FARC to collect distributable revenue to the various tiers of government. A lot of countries in Asia and in Latin America largely depends on agriculture. For places like Malaysia, Brazil, Thailand, and others, agriculture provides their source of foreign earnings. We have a very blessed topography in Nigeria. We have vast arable land that we can use in cultivating various crops. But we have so far not been able to make good use of the potentials God has blessed our environment with. Now, with the realities on ground, economic diversification is not what we will now treat with kid gloves. We have to hit the ground running. There's a need for us to look critically into the agricultural sector, where we're able to provide sustainable food for our people, provide enough that we're able to export and earn income. Agriculture is a very lucrative value chain where you have various types of produces that you can undertake. For example, if you are into fisheries, if you are into crop production, if you are into poultry, if you are into agriculture, if you are into palm oil business, there are a lot of things in the agricultural value chain that gives you real money. With all of these, there's still the need for support, because in going into farming, you will now understand that some of these things you can't just do on your own. There's the need for support. That's why we're not saying, in the era of COVID-19, how do we now introduce innovations that were able to drive sustainable growth? There's a need for us to introduce technology into farming. We can undertake greenhouse farming for those who live in cities, who do not have access to land. You can have a greenhouse farm in your compound where you're able to produce vegetables and other smaller agricultural produces for your family and your immediate use. Where is the place of technology in agriculture today? The youth of today see agriculture as a venture that is meant for old people, but that's very far from the reality. The truth is, agriculture is a business for everybody. It is an investment that has high economic return. If you invest in farming today, within the period of 4, 5, 6, 7 years, you see the exponential growth in your farm venture. So, as part of our drive in trying to see what we can do differently, especially as we begin to champion a new thinking ideology for our people, it is important that we look at, what do I do as an individual to be able to stay afloat now that a lot of organizations have cut down their jobs because they no longer have the client base that they used to have. A lot of services that they used to render have now been cut to at best 50% because the economy is not functioning at optimal capacity. So there are a lot of job losses, but our people should not lose hope. We can still continue to provide the much needed support for them. So those of us who are well informed in the areas of innovations should be able to take these messages to our people at home, that there's a need for all of us to go into a new way of living. If you live in the rural area, You can actually have access to an arable land that you can cultivate on. I remember during the lockdown, a lot of persons were complaining about the prices of garri and foodstuffs. And the question I usually asked was, what is the result of this exponential increase? If those who are supposed to be in the farm are no longer in the farm, you see that there is a geometric increase because the demand has outweighed supply. So it's just a natural economic principle. But if we all embrace one type of farming or the other, we'll be able to, within our immediate environment and community, provide what is sustainable. Then we now look into for those who can invest in large-scale agriculture. Yes, we all know that farming is very expensive, because in trying to get some of the farm implements and improve varieties. But the Central Bank of Nigeria has been able to assist Nigerian farmers with various agricultural development programs, wherein they can have, one, not only access to credit facilities, but before you access the credit facilities, farmers are made to undergo trainings on how best they can manage their farms, how they can have proper accounting, how to assess loans and the others. So, for a country as Nigeria, where we have high rates of unemployment, the only sector that can absorb a mass of youth is the agricultural sector. Beyond the agricultural sector, what can the government do in trying to stimulate the economy? Governments at all levels should invest in critical infrastructures such as mass housing development, road infrastructure, and electricity, because these are areas that have direct impact on economic recovery. Once they invest in mass housing projects, people will be readily employed. Once we invest in electricity, the cost of running businesses will reduce drastically, because a lot of SMEs stay on their independent power they provide by fueling their generators daily. And it's a lot of burden on them. So, if we can solve the issue of power, we'll have to a reasonable extent done a lot in trying to provide support for SMEs. So, my call on our people is, let us take a critical look at this opportunity COVID-19 has provided us. For some persons, they see it as a setback. But for me, I see it as a new opportunity for us to rework our development. For us to sit back and replan and re-strategize on how do we defeat poverty. Because if you look at the opportunities before COVID-19 struck, a lot of individuals, like 80% of those who are in the productive age, do not have jobs. But COVID-19 has now taught us that we can actually go beyond looking for white-collar jobs and invest in production. Those who have made good use of this COVID-19 era will tell you that they've had a remarkable improvement in their livelihood. Because for those producing some of the items we use in trying to curtail the spread of the coronavirus, for example, I'm putting on a face mask. It is a locally made one from fabrics. The tailor that produced this will have made money. The woman selling the material will also make money. The vendor who buys from the tailor to go and sell has also made his own part of the money. What of local production of hand sanitizers with the use of alcohol? We had had increases in local alcohol because of the mass production of hand sanitizers. Before now, a lot of us never believed that we can use alcohol to do some of these things beyond the usual, what they usually buy and drink and put it in some other stores. But today, we have not seen that with what it has presented, COVID-19 has presented before us, we can actually improvise and make alternatives. So, I want to call on our youths to key into the new way of doing things, which is embracing agriculture. Because for us to have sustainable development, we have to be realistic. We must, as a matter of fact, accept the reality that Nigerians need to go back to agriculture. We need to go back to farming. And in going back to farming, there is the need for government at all levels to take this message down to every ward, so that the people will now understand that farming is not a source of poverty, but farming is a pathway to riches and economic growth. That formal understanding of it is only poor people who embark on farming is another major reason why our youths do not see agriculture as what they can go into, because they believe that farming is meant for poor people, people who do not have the right education and knowledge. But for those who are knowledgeable, you will now understand that when you bring in your education into your business, that's why we said exploiting innovations for sustainable economic development. So you bring in your education, it's part of innovating. You bring it into your farming. In trying to do your marketing, you bring in education. In sourcing for support, you need the education, because without education, you will not know how to seek assistance. Where will you be able to access grants? So how do you go into partnership? How do you now take advantage of the various support services that are available in the agricultural value chain? I want to thank you all for listening. Do have a blessed day.